Hey, this is the Daily Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today I want to talk about how app rejections are the new normal. Alright, so last week I released an update to EarSpy, which is my biggest app on the iOS store, on the App Store. Right, and it was a very simple release. The app has been out for, it's been on the App Store since 2012, right? And every so often I'll release just a minor little update, just to update the AdMob libraries, put a new link to terms and conditions in, that kind of stuff. Just a minor update. No new major functionality, nothing like that. And I just released it on last Friday night, and of course Saturday I get a rejection. And can you guess what the rejection is? 4.3 spam, again, for this app. And they say this app is similar to other apps you have on the App Store, and that's completely false. They haven't even looked at it, right? It was just, you know, this is one app that's unique from all the other ones. It doesn't share any of the same code, any of the same functionality, the same description, the same anything as any of the apps on my account, right? But it was flagged up again. It's very similar to last month, where I released a new app, completely new and fresh, and that was hit for 4.3, also spam, right? That's the go-to response. And I argued with them that time and said, this app is not like any of the other ones. I know that you might have an issue with a couple of the apps on my account, which I need to work on, and I went through and I deleted more than half of them, right? But, so I appealed it, and then finally I got somebody on the phone, and they had a look at it and say, okay, yes, I can understand, I'll give this the go-ahead, right? And then it went through. I'm gonna have to do the whole same song and dance with this one, right? Because it's been unjustly rejected, right? And I'm starting to think that this is the new normal. At least it's a new normal for me, right? I feel like I'm on the no-fly list, right? Luckily, when you hear about people who, for whatever reason, got on a no-fly list, every time they travel, it's more difficult for them. And I kind of feel that's the same way with the App Store. I know it's not everybody, because I have clients where we release apps for them, and it's fine. They have no problems. They might get kicked back a little bit for some metadata or something, but for the 4.3, it's not a big deal. Right, and I always think that it's because I have so many apps on the App Store that's the reason it's doing. That's why I'm going through and deleting all of them and removing all the free ones from the App Store. But I'm starting to hear from people. I'm starting to hear from a lot of people who are getting hit from 4.3 when they just have, you know, one or two apps on the App Store. So this is just the new normal. Now I could, you know, feel sorry for myself and just get in a bad mood and say, I'm not going to do the App Store anymore. And by the way, I've done all of those things so far this morning. I'm still a little bit upset, if you can't tell. But I have to go through it. I have to go through and, you know, and just, by the way, when I say appeal, some people are asking about that. I just, like, when they send the rejection through, I just put the response there. Can you have a look at this again, please? This is not correct. If you have a look at any of the other apps, if it can be a container with any of the other apps on my account, please point out which one, because it's beyond me. It doesn't share the functionality or the code or anything with any of the apps on the App Store. But, you know, I mean, I'm dealing in logic, and they're dealing with, I don't want to have to review this. And I really do think that is a case of just, you know, if they're just rubber stamping it, saying, yeah, I don't want to do this one, right? He's got a lot of apps. It's probably similar to one of the other ones, you know, so I got to go through that whole song and dance, and I really am getting tired of the whole Apple thing. It's almost like they don't want the indie developer anymore. I honestly think that. I think that, you know, they're happy with the big apps. They're happy with the Rovios and the King and everything like that. They're good. You know, all that, there's an app for that kind of thing. They're good. They don't need any more. But, you know, I'm just being cynical. I guess, you know, I just need to calm down, get this thing approved, go through the whole thing, get somebody on the phone, work my case. I'm sure that it's going to get approved eventually, you know, but it's just a pain, right? Especially with stuff you got like GDPR, a lot of us need to go through and put terms and conditions into the applications and stuff like that. And that's really hard when every time you try to do something, it's like, ooh, no, you know, they're just like, it's like trying to run with your shoes tied together. I just try and do anything on Apple, they just slowing everything down. So, But, I mean, they're a lot better than they used to be. Usually they take 10 days to come up with a decision like that. At least now I get rejected in a fraction of the time. So, anyway, let me know what you guys... There's not a really good topic for this one, except for the fact that Apple sucks or whatever. I don't want this to just be a rant video, but... You know, I just want to give you guys an update because a lot of you guys go through the same kind of stuff too, and you're not alone. I'm just, you know, it is annoying. It is annoying. So anyway, that's it for today. I'll talk to you guys again tomorrow.